About 9 years ago, I was on the verge of opening up my first business, His Place Ice Cream and Coffee Shop. I was so excited. This was going to be my first business. I had everything planned out. I had borrowed a lot of money, and so much was riding on this. My future expenses, my relationship with my wife if it didn't work out. And so I was telling everybody I knew about His Place Ice Cream and Coffee Shop. You see, my daytime job has always been pharmaceutical sales, selling in dermatology. I've been with this company, Taro Pharmaceutical, for a number of years at that time. Ended up being over 15 years I was with them. But I was with my manager at a crucial time where I made a crucial mistake. You see, naturally, like any business owner, even though I wasn't going to be at the business working, I was the manager, I was the overseer, I was the owner. I had my daughter, Samantha, who was managing it day to day. So I wasn't spending my time there during the week, but I didn't know what would happen if my company knew that I owned this on the side. Was it allowed? I don't know. I didn't ask. And at the point I thought I should ask, if I asked and they said no, would I have to quit my job? So I just hid it. Right? That's all you do. You just hide it and think, I can get away with this. Nobody's going to find out. But of course, as a business owner and somebody that wants this to succeed, any business close to where mine was going to be, all of these doctor's offices close to where I was going to be, I was talking up my business and say, you got to come see what it's like. You got to come check us out when we're open. Well, this one particular fall morning, I had my manager with me. And we went into this pediatric office in Martinsville, Indiana, just 10, 15 minutes away from my shop. And we were in there talking to the normal thing. She was just shadowing me like managers do. And one of the nurses says, "So Kyle, how's your shop coming along? Is it about ready to open?" And I don't know what color my face went, but I know it wasn't normal. My mind is like, what do I say? What do I quickly say? And I said, "Oh, that little thing, that's, my daughter's got it taken care of. She's all got it," trying to play it off. My manager's behind me. I have no idea what she's saying, what she's thinking. I have in my mind what she's probably thinking. But anyhow, we go back out to the car and she asks, "So what is this business they're talking about?" And even then, I try to, that's what we do, right? We cover up a lie with a lie. I'm like, "Oh, my daughter's doing this business and I've been telling about it and all that." But she saw around it. She was smarter than that. And it finally came to it. She asked what really was going on. I had to admit it. I had to tell her, it says, "This is a business that I've started. I'm not running it, not working it every day. I have my manager managing it, but it's my business." And I told them. And she said, "Why didn't you tell me?" She was rightly so upset and angry why I hid this from her and why I was trying to hide this behind her back. And I said, "Well, I didn't know what the company would do." And she said, "You're allowed to have outside interests as long as they don't interfere." It's like, I didn't know that. I didn't want to take a chance. But now, in her mind, I had hurt our trust for our future business. She didn't know if she could trust me when she told me things or what I was telling her was the truth. I had really hurt my trustworthiness for her for quite a while. And that really hurt. And I regret what I did. But how many times, I can't tell you how many times I've done this in my past. How many times have you done something like that, that you just try to cover it up with a lie because you think I can get away with it? And I don't want to face some difficult consequences. What might happen if I tell the truth? In fact, the title of this talk today is I Almost Got Away With It. Almost. But looking back, if it wasn't that, it would have been some other office. And I'm glad God taught me this lesson that that's not the way I want my character, my integrity to be. That's not who I am. And I don't want to show that to her. I think our initial reaction is to lie and hide it up, but that just gets us in trouble. I mean, don't we learn this from childhood? We do something wrong, we lie about it because we don't want to get a spanking. We don't want to get in trouble or time out or whatever we do nowadays. And it accompanied so many of us into adulthood. And we take that same concept of not wanting to tell the truth at times. In fact, the scripture I want to share today is a story most of you have heard, especially if you grew up in the church. And it's about Zacchaeus. So it comes from Luke 19, 1 through 10. And it says, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus, and he was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. You see, the chief tax collectors were the worst of the worst. Tax collectors of those times were the worst kinds of people because they were the people that were charging extra taxes. So the Romans were the ones using their power to keep the Jewish people at the time at bay and force them to do what they wanted them to do. You see, the tax collectors were usually Jewish people, so they were not only working for the enemy, but they were on top of that, often taking an extra 10, 20, 30% off of what the Romans asked for and pocketing it themselves. So they were cheating their own people working for the enemy. So a chief tax collector, somebody in charge, was the worst of the worst to so many Jews back then. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but because he was short, he could not see over the crowd. I can empathize with Zacchaeus on that at many concerts. So when he ran ahead and climbed the sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming his way, when Jesus reached the point, he looked up to him and said, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today." See, Jesus knew his name, just like he knows our name. So he came down and at once welcomed him gladly. All the people saw this and began to mutter, "He's gone to be the guest of a sinner? Those evil guys are going to get him sinner tax collector cooties?" But Zacchaeus stood up and said to him, "Lord, Lord, here now I give half my possessions to the poor. And if I've cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay them four times back the amount." Jesus said to him, today, salvation has come to this house because this man too is the son of Abraham. For the Son of Man, meaning himself, Jesus, came to seek and save the lost." You see, this example shows us how we are to react. We can do things in our past that we screwed up and shouldn't have done, but Jesus redeems us, and we need to take that responsibility and that time to say, I apologize. Forgive me of my sin. And he completely forgives us. So what are some three things to build trustworthiness and integrity into your life? Number one, make your actions match your words. What you're going to say, whether it's in business or in life or at home, say what you're going to do and do it. Hold back or keep your word. That is so rare, unfortunately, in today's culture. Number two, don't assume the worst. We so often want to assume the worst is going to happen, and often that ends up happening because we just assume it's going to happen. Let's look at what positively could happen. And then lastly, be open to feedback. So if somebody criticizes you or gives you ways to get better, like my manager at the time, she was upset, but she told me ways that we could build my trust back up and ways that she could trust me. And I used that and I worked with her. I laid down my pride. So we have to have lives of integrity and trust. And that's so important, not only in the Christian life, but in our business, in our world. We want to be men and women that have integrity. I love the quote, and I'll leave you on this today, from Cary Newhoff. He says, "Do what you said you would do when you would say, when you," let me rephrase that. Let me say it again. "Do what you said you would do when you said you would do it, and you'll be ahead of 99% of the people out there." Think about it. Do what you say you're going to do. Let people trust you. Let people know your word is true. There are very few people that do that these days. Be one of those. Have a great day.